Hello guys, we are back with our next lecture. In this lecture, let us go through the next question. Okay, so this question belongs to GATE CSC 2020. Okay, so the given question is consider a relational database. Okay, so they give a database containing the following schema. Okay, and they are saying the primary key of each table is indicated by underlining the thing. So here the primary key is a serial number. Here it is a parts number. Here it is a serial number plus a parts number, right? Yes. And now the query is, okay, so it is a nested query, right? Select serial number comma name from suppliers as S and catalogs as C, where S dot serial number is equals to C dot catalog number and cost is greater than. So now here the other query is starting. Select average cost from catalog where P number is equals to P4 group by P number. Okay, so I think this question seems to be a bit interesting, right? Yes. So let us start solving the question, guys. Okay, so to be clear, here they are interested in doing average, right? So select average cost from catalog where P number is equals to P4. So we are targeting mainly on this P4 thing, right? I think that's what they are trying to say, right? Yes. So they are targeting on this P4 group by P number. Okay, and they are also trying to perform group by. Then why do they want to perform group by? Okay, so anyway, they are trying to select average, guys. So what is this whole statement goal, guys? So we are going to try to do average of this P4, right? So what will be the average? It is nothing but 200 plus 250 divided by 2, which is nothing but 450 divided by 2. That is nothing but 225, right? Yes. Okay, so now after solving this whole part, we got 225 as the result. Okay, so now let us read the statement again. So the given statement is select S number comma S name. So S number and S name are available in this table and from suppliers as S. So basically they converted this into S and catalog as a C, where S dot S number is equals to C dot S number. So we are matching this with this and we are checking whose cost is greater than 25. Okay, so we are searching for the people whose thing is greater than 25, right? Sorry, greater than 225. So let us first tick whose values are greater than 225, guys. So here we are having greater than 225. Here we are having greater than 225. Here we are having greater than. Okay, so let me write it in this way, guys. So this is greater than 225. 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 So a total of four entries, we got greater than 225, right? Yes. So what do we do? So we will start printing these values. So S2, we will write S2 Miss Bajaj Furniture. So this is what you will print for once. And then you will print for S3, you will print this particular item. For again, for S3, you will print this again. For S3, you will print this again. So a total of four prints will be done, right? Yes. So the question is also that only. So they are saying how many rows will be printed. So a total of four rows will be printed, right? Yes. So if you want me to then say the full row, it will be S2 P5 250 S2 Miss Bajaj Bangalore. Similarly, S3 P1 250 S3 Miss Premium Furniture and Chennai. Similarly, S3 P5 300 MS Miss Premium Furniture Chennai. Similarly, S3 P4 250 Miss Premium Furniture Chennai. So in that way, four rows will be printed, right? Yes. But as we are printing only S name comma serial number, so this will be printed once, this will be printed three times, right? Yes. So as this is SQL, so duplicates are allowed, so that is the reason why four is the answer. Got it? Yes. So it's a quite interesting question and it's directly based on the table, right? So that is the reason why the question has become really easy, right? Yes. Okay, so now I hope everyone got a clear idea with respect to this question. So in the next lecture, let us continue with the next question. Okay? Yes. So let us meet in the next lecture. Thank you. Thanks for watching. Like, share and subscribe for more awesome videos like this. Thank you.